All my horses that come to my house, they all learn to put their head down. It's a simple little trick that they all learn, but it's a big concession on any horse. When he learns to drop that eye lower than your eye, it's okay, I give. You are the leader of the herd, and I will listen to what you say. A lot of horses, when you first get them, they can see that they're tougher than you are. Their head goes up. They want to throw their head. And they raise their eye higher than yours to try to tell you, hey, you can't tell me what to do. I think I'm tougher than you are. So this little device I put on him called a sugar string, developed long before me. It developed over 100 years ago. You don't see it very often. This horse already conceded. He doesn't want to disagree with me. Part of that's because when I loaded him in California last week, he didn't lead very good. We had to have a leading lesson. So as soon as I put this on him, he conceded. I can see. But when I lower that head lower than my eye, he pretty soon, hey, I don't want to fight. And if you watch baby colts in the pasture, they run up to another horse, they don't understand, they start dropping their neck, and their mouth starts working. Hey, I don't want to fight, I want to be green. So that's where this has all come from. Most everything I teach comes from Mother Nature. And people ask me how I developed these. I didn't develop them. Most of them have been around the movie business and horse world for 100 years. I've just taken advantage of every one of the trainers I've ever been around and had the chance to work with and try to learn from every one of them. You can learn from anybody and everybody every day if you're willing to be open-minded. So I start here teaching them to drop that head. And that is the foundation then later when I want this horse to start bowing, he must be able to drop that head. But I also want him to pick this leg up. When I've got my hand, it's a big nail that they use for log homes. It's very dull. It's not meant to break the skin. It's simply made like a fly ear taking that leg. And all I want him to do is pick that leg up. And I'm going to sit here, and I'll take my time. I got all day. The only thing that training horses is persistent patience. And being persistent, all right, hey, yeah, you don't understand, do you? But I'll just sit here and take my time. A lot of times I get rushed. Hey, boy. All I asked him to do was pick that leg up. I didn't want him to paw. If he pawed, I kept bumping that sugar string until he quit. He's getting upset. He don't understand. Well, I just take my time. I got all day. Hey, good boy. All I wanted him to do is pick that leg up and break it for me and not get all worried about it. And I can sit here and be patient. I've got 45 minutes. So I can sit here now waiting. I've got way more time than he does, so I can just sit here and take my time. You cannot get in a hurry with anything you teach one. You get in a hurry, you're getting in trouble. You can't say, oh, he schooled him at home and brought him. I could have brought 25 of them. I wanted one that hadn't been messed with at all. So you can see, he's pushing me around, me around, I ain't getting upset about it. I just take my time. And pretty soon he's going to get tired of me agitating his leg, and he's going to pick that leg up. That's all I ask him to do, pick that leg up. And we find out, oh, that wasn't hard. I guess I can do that all day long. When he does, you're going to find out it's not a big deal to sit here and hold this leg up for him. And drop his head. And that's the basis of my bow. He doesn't realize it, but he's already bowed because he just broke his shoulder right there for me. And he doesn't even realize it yet. There it is, almost there. But if I'd have got mad and I'd have went pecking at him and picked a fight with him, he would have done anyway. So I just sat here and talked to you guys. Had all day. Hey, and keep buffing, real light on that trigger string. It's not brain surgery. With brain surgery, I wouldn't be doing it, but I didn't graduate from college. So, it is very, well, maybe a cheap one. Hey, relax. It's simply being patient. Hey, good boy. It's very easy. Whoa, relax. I'm going to take the trigger string off one because he's already too touchy to it. I don't know, put a war bridle on you. The war bridle has been around thousands of years. It's been used for centuries to train horses. It's a very simple, if the kids lariat, there's 100 different variations of it. This is the variation I use the most. Because years ago, when we done Black Stallion, Capital A was notorious for being able to slip it off over his head. Because he's very small, keen ears, he shaved his head and flipped it off. And he did, I still got him, because I got rope around his neck. If you use several of the other variations, you'll lose them when they flip it off over their ears. You no longer have any control over it, and you've lost them. We live in Sahara Desert, on a piece of thousands of miles. We don't want to lose them as fast as we've never been outdoors. Out of a box stall, and if you did get out and lost, you panic. So now, with this, he still wants to put his head down. And now I'll make him hold it for a second. Put him today. I want him to learn this one today. Every time I touch that leg, and you can see all I did with that leg. And that's in search of softness. Same way this, probably going to get very soft today. Doing that trigger. So if I was to then transfer to a whip, I would sit here and start pecking that leg before. And first go back to where I started, just picking the leg up. Good boy. This is not a dumb horse at all. I'm very impressed with many good picks to go do the deal in New York with. But there again, I'm just going to be patient. Good boy. Now, because I have time constraints, I'm going to make him do this. Good boy. Don't ever get mad at him, because you're never going to be bigger and stronger than they are. You are 10 times smarter than they are. Outthink them. You outthink them. You have all that problem. Thank you very much, everybody, for coming today. I hope you learned something. AQHA brought me here, and everybody thanks him for bringing me. Thank you.